Not since Columbus discovered the Americas. Not since Cortez toppled the Aztec Empire. Not since Taco Bell introduced the 59-cent taco has there been a force so powerful, so intense, so calculatingly chingon. Who are these ambassadors of Latino comedy? Culture Clash!
Boys, there are three vessels in the harbor, ready to take us back to the old world. The Rosarita, the Charo, the Maria Conchita Alonso. I fear, however, that the King and Queen of Spain will ask me to do one final voyage. This I cannot do, boys. I'm old. I'm tired. I'm trying to get out of the shipping business. But they keep pulling me back in! What is it, my little half and half?
There's an Indian woman waiting outside to see you.
It's some Indian broad. Says her name's America.
America? The beautiful. Let the bimbo in!
Don Colon, buenos dias. Thank you for letting me see you. I bring before you my only son, the last son of Chief Anacaona. I beg of you, Don Colon, give him your blessing.
You want me to dip that bean? No way, Jose! I killed Chief Anacaona. When he grows up to be an Indian activist, he's gonna wanna rip my heart out. He's gonna wanna avenge his father's death, see? And worst of all, he's gonna boycott my quincentennial celebration. That's bad business, America.
No, Don Colon, please. Not this child. He is weak. I'll make sure he grows up to be a good little Indian and celebrate Columbus Day.
No, Dice. I'm gonna ask you to give a little tonto over here to my son, Ferdinand. Go ahead.
No, please.
Hey, that's no baby there. She's got a Ginzu knife.
We were here long before the vessels of death arrived. You murdered, plundered, and raped under the guise of Christianity. Prepare to die, you!
Yo, Pops, I got it right between the eyes. Yeah. Vinny, how come you just stood there and didn't do nothing?
Why didn't you defend my honor, son?
Because she is my mother.
His mother?
My mother! You killed my mamma mia! I am confused and full of rage!
Baby, I'm sorry it came to this, son. But maybe it's best you just forget your Indian past.
Never!
Oh, baby. You're confused. You're full of rage. But then again, your history's best. Chicano!
Chicano?
He's a Chicano. Ferdinand, now you know about your half-brother. I should have never gotten involved with America. Oh, but she was virgin territory. Ferdinand, you're my true blue son. I want to give you the shipping business, capiche? Oh, your brother Vinny, he's just gonna get in your way. Comprendes, Mendes?
Give me the order, Pop. Give me the order!
Guacamole with chips. That's just an old joke, idiot. Here!
Oh.
what you have done, Don Colon. You raped and murdered my mother, America, and you hire my brother to assassinate.
Stop the dramatic, Vinny! You're no Placido Domingo, son.
One day my people will populate this so-called new world. Why will own legitimate businesses? One day a dark little Indian will sit on the L.A. County Board of Supervisors.
No!
Your time has come, Don Colon. I am El Nuevo Hombre, a product of both worlds, and I have no idea why I'm speaking in an English accent.
Put the gun down.
No!
Put the gun down, Vinny!
No!
What are you going to do? What, you going to shoot me, Vinny? You going to shoot your papa, huh? Me, the great explorer, huh? Come on. We can't rewrite history, son. I didn't die this way, you fool!
Let us say, this is more symbolic than factual, Papa. This is for 500 years of genocide. This is for all Native Americans. This one's for La Raza. This one's for Fernando Valenzuela.
I'm dead already. My wig's still off and I can't get up.
Happy Columbus Day, Papa.
We went over this already, Holmes. I can't make it to the U.S. out of East L.A. rally, man. Because I'm busy, man. Something heavy is coming down for La Raza. Something that's going to have impact on the barrio, man. The 49ers are playing. Hey, don't question my commitment to La Raza, all right? I was a Chicano way before you were, man. When's the next colectiva, man? I'll make it to the next meeting. Thursday night, huh? Damn, that's L.A. law night. Okay. All right, then. No, I'm going to make it up to you, Batos, man. I'm going to put up flyers everywhere for the Sensitive Chilean Lesbian Poetry Festival. Simón. Yeah. Que viva la mujer, man. Yeah. Okay, Holmes. So I'll catch you on the rebound, Holmes. Órale. A rato, man. Yeah. Chicano power, man. Yeah. We shall overcome, Holmes. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. James Brown is free, pendejo. Chingao! Man, being an activist in the 90s is gonna be more difficult than I thought, comandante. There's not too many of us radicals left around anymore. What happened to the revolution, man? The decade of the Hispanic turned out to be a weekend sponsored by Coors. The only way to get back a slan is the way you did it, comandante. Total liberation through armed revolution. ¡Que viva Che! Chingao, I'm missing the game.
San Francisco 49ers.
Come on, Joe!
The L.A. Raiders. Montana to throw. Ooh, he gets that.
Oh, chingao, man. Come on, Montana. Hey, Domino's. I'm gonna be getting the munchies pretty soon, eh? Simon, Holmes. Yeah, pepperonis, Holmes. Yeah. No jalapenos. I'm boycotting those this week. Yeah. Hey, man, tell Frankie to bring it. I like that crazy vato. Later, man. Come on, Montana! Hey, come on in. It's opening.
¿Cómo está, brother?
¿Cómo
está, coño?
Oh, no.
Un abrazo, Brian. Un abrazo. Tinga. Hey, Chuy, how you like the way I look? I just got my Santeria kit today. Orale. I got 1-900-VOODOO. I come to pick you up tonight. Okay. Tonight we are going to dance una salsita caliente, mano. Mm. Celia Cruz, Celia Cruz.
You're gonna take me by Lando, carnal. Man, I've been working on my salsa step all week long.
Quiero ver, no, aquí vamos. Vamos. Chuy, muévete. Las nalgas, las nalgas. It's okay, Chuy, it's okay. At least you're better than white people.
Hey, Holmes. Hey, man, you just got back from Cuba, man. How's the music over there in Cuba, Holmes?
Está bien chévere, Chuy. Pero se dice Cuba, not Cuba.
Oh, excuse me.
Chuy.
Hey, Holmes. Hey, how's the revolution, man? Fidel hasn't sold out, has he, man?
Ah, huh? No. Fidel is like a mountain that cannot be moved, Chuy.
That vato amazes me, Juan Santero. He's been governing those gentes for over 30 years, man. He has escaped endless assassination attempts. How does he do it, Issy?
He's protected, Chuy. Hey. He's protected by the orishas. By voodoo dolls given to him by a high priestess of Santeria.
Dolls? Muñecas?
Sí?
Like Barbie and Rainbow Bright?
No, these are dolls with spiritual powers, like this one. I brought this one back from the Voodoo Expo show in Havana. This doll can do anything to anybody, living or dead.
Well, if you think the little muñeca's got magical powers, man, why don't you help out the Niners? Montana looks like mierda.
They're losing?
Sí.
Okay, I show you. Hold that. Uy. Vamos, Jojo, Montana.
Pistols down by three. Chengalere. Down. No timeouts. They're at their own 10-yard line with only 3 seconds on the clock.
Vamos, Jojo, Montana.
There's the snap. Montana to throw. No, wait a minute. He looks like he's gonna run. Oh, he'll lose one tackler. He breaks another. This is amazing. Montana's at the 50, the 40. He looks possessed. He's at the 30. That's why. Oh, I'm coming. Knockdown. Knockdown, 49ers. They win. Joe Montana doing the merengue in the end zone. The white boy's got rhythm.
It works, Juan Santero. The muñeca really works.
Te dije, coño.
Ese, can that thing bring back the dead, Holmes?
Of course it can. In fact, last night, I was playing Babaloo with Desi Arnaz.
Let me borrow the muñeca. Dámelo!
Okay, Chuy. Look, I lend you the doll. Whatever you do, it must come from the corazón. It must be for the good of the people. And more important than anything else, may la fuerza be with you. Okay, Chuy. I got to go now. I got to go to a Santeria Tupperware party. One more thing. The facts with history, man. The facts with history. Okay, Chuy. I see you tonight, man. Okay? Tu me hiciste Santeria. Tu me hiciste Santeria.
Wow. It's up to me and you, Janet Jackson. We gotta light the fires of radicalism, mijita. The leftist movement needs a good shot in the arm. We got Chicanos out in the suburbs driving fancy cars y todo. We got beaners and beamers. Okay, amiga, let's bring them back alive, baby. Come on, let's start the revolution. Andale. Oye, ¿cómo va? Got a black magic woman. Come on, baby. Come on, andale. Okay, ¿dónde está? Where is he? Where's the revolution? ¿Dónde está? Where is he? Oh, chingao, man. I've been fooled again by pinche Juan Santero and his stupid tricks. I can't believe I fell for this one, man. I'm calling the Better Brujeria Bureau. Oh, Oh, come on, Holmes. I hope it's the pizza. Come on in, Holmes. Domino's does deliver.
Who are you?
I'm Chewy. This is Juana La Cubana. A sus órdenes, comandante.
Callate, pibe. Sos mexicano.
No, I'm a Chicano.
¿Qué es Chicano? What country?
Aztlán, comandante.
¿Qué es Aztlán, pibe?
Aztlán is the land that the Yankees stole away from the Chicanos. Yeah. It's a southwest, comandante. Check it out. It's Colorado,
sí.
New Mexico, Texas, East LA, Oxnard.
Los Estados Unidos.
Sí, comandante.
¿Por where, compañero?
Comandante, welcome to Berkeley.
Berkeley. Macanudo.
It's the last communist stronghold in the whole pinche world.
Sí.
Comandante, I would be so honored if you were to sit in my lazy boy at...
Oh, sí,
I have so many things to tell you. I don't know where to begin. Basically, you're dead.
What? Get.
They killed you in the mountains in Bolivia in 67. Some said that Fidel was behind the whole thing.
Nunca!
No, I don't believe it either. I don't believe it either. So with the help of my compañero, we brought you back from the dead. People have forgotten what you fought and died for. Chicanismo's on the way down. Stairmasters are on the way up, comandante. I've been waiting for this moment all my life, comandante. ¿Sabes qué? You got a rifle?
Yeah.
Yo también. ¿Sabes qué? We're gonna go downtown and take over City Hall. ¡Vámonos!
¡Alto, idiota! Compañero! We cannot engage in guerrilla warfare at the present time. No. We need a strategic plan. First, I need a political and historical update since my death.
Ay, comandante! What luck! I've got just the book right here. A political and historical update since the death of Che.
Is it Russian?
No, by James Michener.
Bueno, okay.
Comandante, basically, there has been some good news and there has been some bad news.
Tell me the good news.
Bueno, Nicaragua had a Marxist government.
¡Que viva Nicaragua!
But they were voted out of power 2 years ago.
¡Qué malo, Nicaragua!
We lost Czechoslovakia, Romania, and Bulgaria.
¿Qué? Bulgaria, Yugoslavia.
Sí.
What happened to Russia, the Communist Party?
The party's over, Holmes.
Kill off!
Remember the Berlin Wall?
Sí.
Se cayó.
Se cayó la pared de Berlín.
Crumble right to the ground.
Qué horror!
Sí.
What happened to La China?
La China.
La China.
She lives in Monterey Park. Wanna call her?
Compañero, this is very confusing.
Yo sé.
Tell me something. Who won the Vietnam War?
The Vietnamese.
¡Que viva!
And then they moved to Orange County.
What has the left done anything since I died?
Oh, sí, comandante. The left has made many strides since your death. Chile had a Marxist president.
¡Qué bueno!
But the CIA killed him in 73.
¡Qué malo!
Grenada had a Marxist government.
¡La victoria!
But now it's a Club Med.
¡Mierda!
Special thanks to former President Ronald Reagan.
Ronald Reagan? Sí. Ronald Reagan?
Sí.
The actor from Hollywood? The guy who did movies with chimpanzees? Bonzo goes to Washington?
Yeah, except he left Bonzo at home. He took Nancy to Washington.
Yeah.
Comandante, these are crazy times. Comunismo's on the way down. Capitalismo is on the way up. I'm a little confused myself about one little fact, comandante.
Decime.
When did you go out with Evita?
Evita Perón?
Sí.
I was a little child when she was in power. Sounds like a Broadway musical. What are you trying to tell me, compañero? Are you saying that suddenly the spirit of internationalism has died? That the philosophy, the ideology of los compañeros Marx and Lenin has faded? That I died in the mountains in Bolivia, all in vain?
Ay, comandante! That's no reason to overact and spit on the fascist subscribers in the front row. Comandante, you gotta pull yourself together, si, comandante. Comandante. With all due respect, you're acting like a pussy, Holmes.
Si, Holmes.
Comandante, don't forget, you inspired a whole generation of yuppies, comandante. And besides, you made a handsome silkscreen poster. You had some commercial impact, too.
Commercial impact? Yo, como?
You know Carl's Jr.'s hamburgers?
Si?
Where do you think they got the Happy Star from?
The Happy... No! 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 No!
Now, Joey! Yo, homie! Get your funky face piece of melted cheese!
Hey, yo, 29 minutes, 30 seconds!
I only hit three people, too!
That's good!
Who's the hippie?
Hey, yes, sir, have some respect, I brought that vato back from the dead.
The dead?
Simon.
Is that Jerry Garcia?
Oh, that's Che.
Oh, yeah, Che.
Che.
Yo, Desert Storm, right?
Yo, what's up?
That's the Chicano handshake.
Man, don't you have some respect, Frankie, man? Don't you know who this vato is? Ernesto Che Guevara. I brought him back from the dead. I said, check this out. This vato, he used to go up into the mountains and train gorillas like Sigourney Weaver did.
Okay.
Then... the vato would come down and overthrow the governments. He's a gorilla in our midst.
Hey.
Man, I think I read about him in Trivial Pursuit. Yo, on the side of the underdog, eh?
Hey.
Yo, man, sometimes I feel like I'm an underdog. Mm. Delivering these pizzas, getting minimum wage. And I still owe $6,000 on my Mazda mini truck. You know something? Me and the guys at work, we were thinking of calling a rally, a strike, for better wages.
See?
Well, except we don't know how because, well, we're confused and full of rage.
Compañero, you remind me of Cuba.
Cuba.
Excuse me. Compañeros, let me demonstrate something very basic. Domino's Pizza represents the Yankee oppressor.
Yo, that's red, white, and blue.
Muy bien. You are the oppressed worker, Frankie. We must, compañeros, crush the oppressor.
What the hell, man?
Compañeros, we must seize the means of production. I have a strategic plan. Frankie, we will overthrow your pizzeria. Then, we will overthrow the entire franchise. And Domino's will fall one by one.
That's brilliant!
Yo, man, that's live!
That's the Domino's theory. Compañero, are you ready to struggle?
I'm down with you, Holmes.
Compañero Chubby, are you ready to die?
No.
Frankie, un grito para la liberación.
Ah!
El pueblo unido jamás será vencido.
Compañeros comunistas, compañeros de la revolución.
Come on, Chewy.
Compañeros,
let's wake up the people in the 90s.
Compañeros de la revolución.
revolución. Compañeros, I gotta prepare myself for the revolution. I'm gonna do some push-ups, man, you know, cause I just wanna be ready. I'll probably be the first one to go down when the chingazo starts, you know. I'm just that kind of a vato, you know. Chingao, am I ready to die? Vato takes himself kind of seriously, you know? Comandante! I'm right behind you, Comandante! I'm just gonna watch the 49er highlights first, and then I'll be right there, Holmes.
Well, Joe, you won the game in the last seconds, but you broke 3 ribs, and it looks like you're out for the rest of the season. Oh, 1 second, Joe. This just came in. 2 men tried to hold up a Domino's pizzeria minutes ago. One dressed like communist leader and Broadway star, Che Guevara, was killed. The other, identified as Frank Lopez, escaped and was heard yelling he would overthrow Domino's pizzerias and Taco Bells and then take a run for the border. More news at 11. Back to the...
Oh, Chihuahua. That's a bummer, man. Joe Montana's gonna be out the whole season.
Grandfather. Hey, abuelo. I first remember you when I was 5 years old. You used to get this handkerchief. You grab it by the tips, twirl it in the air, and then you'd start chasing me all over the place. And at the right moment, you'd snap my butt with it. And damn, it would hurt. But you know something, abuelo? I loved every minute of it. He died when he was 93 years old, back in 1978. Well, 2 years ago, I got to see him again. On September 7th, 1989, we were having a culture clash meeting at my house in San Francisco. There was a fight outside. We went outside to take a look. There was this gang, and they were beating up on a kid real bad. I said, hey, leave him alone. He's had enough. Well, it was dark outside, but I could see from about 12 feet away. There was somebody in a trench coat that pulled out a sawed-off shotgun. I saw a flash of light, and I was shot.
The gunshot blast caused my lungs to collapse. I was shot in my liver. I was shot in the colon. And I was shot in my heart.
Like a movie, slow dancing with death. Each breath I thought was going to be my last. My life was slipping away, slowly, gently, delicately.
Wait a minute. What was Santana doing there?
I was ready to die. But I got angry. I felt ripped off. I mean, this is the way I'm gonna leave this place? This isn't the way it's supposed to be. I'm not ready to go. I mean, one minute we're planning on how we're gonna come down here to LA and make people laugh. And then the next minute, some gang member blows me away. He was 17 years old. A kid with a big gun. Well, after I got shot, I got knocked down to the ground. But my homeboy, my buddy Richard, was there for me. He said, "Rick, is there anything I can do?" I said, "Yeah, Rich, call 911. He said, "Okay, what's the number?" Ay, ay, ay. Hey, abuelo, it was good to see you again. Thanks for being there. My doctor says I'm 85% now. Chingao. I wonder where the 15% went.
On the storm, Chicanos on the storm, into this house we're born, into this stage we're thrown, like a dog without a bone, an artist without a brand, Chicanos on the storm, yeah. Who are you?
Enigma.
Who am I?
Rico Suave.
Where am I?
In the barrio streets of your mind, all chuckled line.
Why am I here?
Because, silly, you're confused and full of rage. Now, let's take our medicine. Just relax. Today is our Christopher Columbus 2-for-1 special. You may ramble on an extra hour if you wish. The doctor is always listening. Have an extra special visit.
Nursey?
Did you have a question?
Yes, nurse, my question is this. What will happen to the word Chicano?
The word Chicano?
Yes.
will be replaced in the 90s.
My God, with what?
The new term is tropical anal miss.
I'm a tropical anal mist.
Have a nice day.
No! I'm crazy! I'm a crazy son of a bitch! I'm a loco desperado, I'm not so in the cabeza! I'm your postmodern Mexican hamburger helper! Brothers and sisters, run! Run for the hills! Have you heard the news? Madonna wants to play Frida Kahlo in a movie, man! Oh, it kind of pisses me off! I finally got myself a hero and she's gonna screw it all up for me! What the hell you looking at up there, man? Ain't you never seen a multicultural nightmare coming unglued right before your very eyes, huh? Cause I'm Spanish, I'm Indian, American Indian, I dances with wolves kind of Indian. Oh! I'm a walking, talking Grant Ryder's dream, baby. Whoa! Is that the LA Festival in my pants or did I just cash my NEA check? Ignore the dents, ignore the critics. They don't understand my sensitive, multicultural, multi-personality ways. How can they understand it? I don't understand it, and I wrote this shit during a commercial. I never read Kafka. I never read Tolstoy. I don't even know the words to La Bamba. I'm a Chicano trapped inside the Beverly Center, and I can't get out. I'm tired of being a whore for your laughter. I want your frickin' respect. I want you inside of me this very moment. The pit of my stomach feels like a Marquez novel. Love in the time of colorization. So, I bought me one of those 99-cent Virgin de Guadalupe candles the other day. And the little virgin's got a price barcode attached to the bottom of her feet, right there above the little angel. That little fella that's held her up all these years now looks like a zebra. So, I joined me one of those benevolent Hispanic organizations like MALDEF or LULAC. This one's called MOCOS. It stands for Mexicans or Chicanos or something. We don't have any bylaws. We're just trying to keep our noses clean. We're trying to maintain our chili eating ability.
I wanted to be white when I was a kid. I wanted to be white like this jacket. I wanted to be white like my little pal Joshua. That sucker was white, man. He had little purple veins popping out of his little head. He was my little gringo trophy, he was. It's not that I was ashamed of who or what I was, no siree. I was proud to be African-American. And I wanted to be white for simple reasons, for disciplinary reasons. White kids never got whipped. We were always getting whipped at our house. My old man could drive a car, turn around, and hit 10 kids with one swipe. Boom, boom! I went to kindergarten thinking my middle name was Cabrón. Over at Joshua's house, his mother would always tell us to hush. Everybody hush! I love the sound of that word, man, but I never did quite grasp the concept. Because over at our house, it was ¡Cállate los hijos! If you said a cuss word at Joshua's house, his mother would wash out your mouth with soap and water. If you said a cuss word at our house, you got your mouth washed out with jalapenos. After I got in trouble at my house, I used to run over to Joshua's house, call his mama Puta just to get a soapy rinse job. I never, ever understood the bedtime stories we were told as children either. Well, like most kids, we'd get tucked in and we'd say our prayers, but here's where the story differs. Then our aunt would come in the room. The aunt with no teeth and a faint mustache.
and she would proceed to tell us the wonderful folkloric bedtime story of La Llorona! La Llorona killed 5 children in her sleep. Mijo, tonight I'm going to tell you about La Llorona. Esa muchacha took her little mocosos down to the river and she drowned the cabrones. Ay, que fuerte la mujer mexicana, mija. Now you go to bed, mijo. Sweet dreams, mijito. Don't forget to pray to La Virgen. And don't forget about La Llorona. And then they wondered why we peed the bed at night. I was a child prodigy of the Chicano movement. My instrument was my mouth. One night, true story, Cesar Chavez, Presidente of the United Farm Workers of America, he comes over to our house for dinner, an auspicious and true occasion. And my mother whipped up all this fanciful Mexican food with her very own hands, tamales, beans, and rice, all laid out right there in front of Cesar. And he didn't touch a lick of it. He was fasting that night. I recognized a window of opportunity, and I asked him if I could have his chili relleno. It was mistook as a sexual advancement. I was sent to my room with no dinner, and that night, in solidarity with Caesar, I fasted too. The Chicano movement ended for me the day my parents got a divorce. I remember very clearly my daddy pulling his Volkswagen van out of our driveway. My old man was Cesar Chavez to me. He was Che Guevara, too. Come to think of it, he was always pissed off because the front lawn looked like a jungle. Something happened to me that day. I quit wanting to be white. I had finally come to grips and happily embraced my Japanese heritage. I would like to dedicate a little song to El Movimiento and to my parents. Bob Dylan for the United Farm Workers Union.
De colores en los campos de la primavera. It was the secret fantasy of every bato living in and out of the Pachucada to be a math teacher. The story I'm about to tell you is about two pendejos with the gangbanging PCP instead of EMC square. Órale con zafos, vámonos! Órale gallo! What a waste of pinche time, no gente. Look at the cholo with the shiny calcos, twin mirrors of despair. Look at his net head.
Looks like Spider-Man. Look at the rocker with his tight puto jeans. Makes his ass look like an apricot, no? After teaching math at East LA High School, I decided to open up my own business. Ike. But I wanted to continue to help helpless mocosos like these become good working citizens. So relax, enjoy the pretense. This is the story of Stand and Deliver Pizza Que La Chingada.
Hey, Mr. Escalante. I understand you need somebody to make and deliver pizzas 3 p.m. to midnight, Monday through Friday. Ese vato loco, carnal, ese vato loco, homeboy.
Don't try to outpachuco me, ese. Did you graduate from Garfield?
No.
You know how to read?
No.
You know how to count?
1, 2, tu abuela.
Wise ass, huh? But you don't even know who Shakespeare was.
I kiss thy fair maiden as the singlets flow in the ebb of night.
Órale, cholo. Is that from Richard III?
No, 2 vatos from Verona.
Oh, yeah. You got the ganas?
Simón que yes.
You got a lowrider?
I sure do.
You got a job.
Órale.
Munchies! I want a burrito, dude. Hurry up.
It's a pizzeria. Make them a piece, Cholo.
What? Oh, look who they got working here, man. It's Mr. Cholo Lowrider Loser. Hey, I don't want that gangbanger touching my piece of pizza.
Why?
He's gonna put some jalapenos under, man.
Hey, you better cool it, coconut. I just got this job and I don't want to blow it, eh?
Why don't you just base him, Iculo, you pot of LaBar La Bamba loser?
That's it, you die, come on!
You see, Raza! 2 brown brothers, different from each other, not seeing the reality of their own ignorance. Ignorance breeds violence. Violence breeds ignorance. And ignorance breeds Republicans. What these vatos need is someone who
Hey! Republicans make long speeches. Hurry up, asshole.
What these vatos
need... Come on, Kimo. Our arms are getting very, very tired.
What these vatos need is someone who believes in them again. Someone who will give them a second chance. Someone who's out of their pinche mind like me.
You lucky he froze us.
Yeah, I would have kicked your butt, Cholo.
Oh, yeah? Surfer?
A Chicano?
Stoner?
A Los Tigres de Norte 8-track tape listener?
Oh, yeah? You Axl Rose 7-Eleven Slurpee drinking MTV white boy wannabe?
And Beaner?
Sellout?
Greaser?
Coconut?
Hispanic?
Calmantes, montes, patas, chicas! Enough of this pedo. You're gonna respect this pizzeria like the world. Live in peace and in harmony. Rucker? I'm gonna give you a job.
Excellent, Kimo.
I'm gonna start you at $2.50 an hour.
That's bogus, Kimo.
Okay, $7.25 a day.
That sounds killer.
Cholo! Shake hands.
Oh, man.
Shake hands. You work together. Go on. Chicano handshake.
I might not know it.
Yes, you do. Say you're sorry.
Sorry, Cholo!
Hug each other.
What?
Thank you. kiss each other. Are you two Tijuana putos ready? Get over here. I'm gonna teach you boys how to make the house special. The Edward James Olmos pizza. First you need the dough. Then the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez tomato sauce. See how it runs? Some pachuco pepperoni, y qué? Olives from Miami, vice. You stick it in the oven. You wait till it's farm worker brown. You take it out. Put it in the box, take it in your lowrider, and deliver to the barrio. You get that?
That's easy, like 1, 2, 3.
Like ABC, dudes.
Let's make pizza, boys. Okay. Yeah.
Free. La vida loca for you and me. La vida loca, that's the way it should be.